Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Burke County Board of Commissioners pre-agenda meeting for Wednesday, July 5th, 2017. Welcome everybody. Everybody's present except Commissioner Taylor. Hopefully he'll come in shortly. I'll ask you to silence your mobile devices if you have those, and plan to come to the table up front and use the microphone if you have presentations to make this afternoon so that everybody can hear you. All right, gentlemen, you've had the agenda for today's meeting for some time. I'll entertain a motion to approve the agenda.
So moved, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Wayne. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. All right, presentations. We have none scheduled. We do have a scheduled public hearing. That comes from Community Development Zoning Map Amendment ZMA 2017-06. Peter, thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. How you doing, board? Good to see everybody this afternoon. I hope y'all had a good 4th of July. We're entertaining zoning map amendment 2017-06, a request from a Jesse Jones. He recently purchased some property on US 70. That property along that area used to be in Drexel's ETJ. If you recall, several years ago, Drexel relinquished quite a number of parcels back to the county. At that time, the county just assimilated the zoning into the county zoning. There wasn't a study done to see what each individual parcel was zoned or what use was being accomplished on the property. At that time, we just took their zoning and assimilated it into the county. In this particular case, and a few others, now that we found out, Mr. Jones' property that he purchased has two commercial structures on it. It used to be an auto repair, auto parts store, and he was wanting to rent that those structures out for commercial use, and the folks came in to get permits, and we weren't able to issue those permits because that Drexel zoning was residential for whatever reason. And when all those parcels came into the county, it just became residential as well. So in order to permit a commercial use of the property has to be zoned general business. That's what Mr. Jones is asking for, to zone the property from the current R1 zoning to general business. Right next door is a auto sales lot as well. That's also zoned residential. And speaking with Mr. Jones, we asked him if he wanted the neighbor to come in and do this as a combination rezoning. I guess that the neighbor declined to do so. So it's just the one property that we have a request to rezone to general business. If y'all have any questions, I'll be glad to help entertain those.
All right, thanks, Peter. Any questions for Peter on this matter? This has been commercial property for a long time.
Years and years.
If there are no questions, then we'll leave this on the agenda. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
All right, this brings us to our consent agenda. Item number one on the consent agenda is designation of voting delegate for the NCAC's annual conference. A number of commissioners are planning to attend. In fact, I think Commissioner Mulway, Carswell, myself, and Taylor plan to attend. We do need to designate a voting delegate. Anybody particularly like to do that job? Carswell, would you like to do that? You are perhaps a little more attached to there than some of the rest of us. I think we all plan to be there, but if it's, you can tell me what's good. I think it'll be fine on that. So if it suits everybody, designate Johnny. All right, do we need any further action on that, Madam Clerk? We all good? All right, thank you. That brings us to item two, clerk reappointment removal of WPCOG Regional Aging Advisory Committee, presented by Madam Clerk.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, members of the board. The county appoints four members to the 16-member Regional Aging Advisory Committee. The COG Aging Director, Tina Miller, requests the reappointment of Eleanor Summers to seat number two for a two-year term and the removal of Stephanie Baker. Ms. Baker has served the maximum number of terms allowed. So this is a request to appoint Ms. Eleanor Summers for a two-year term ending June 30th, 2019, and to remove Ms. Baker and thank her for her service.
All right. Any questions? Okay. Hearing none, this item will remain on the agenda without objection. Item number three, clerk appointment to the BSS Board. Madam Clerk.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, members of the board. This is a request to appoint Lisa Dean. The commissioners appoints two of the five members on the Board of Social Services. Mary Ellen Weesey's term ended June 30th, and she is not seeking reappointment. In your packet, you have a letter from the DSS director, as well as Ms. Dean's application, but the term is for 3 years, and of course, we would thank Ms. Weesey for her service as well.
Questions on this item? Hearing none, it'll, without objection, remain on the agenda. Item four, clerk, East Burke Senior Center reappointments. Madam Clerk.
Thank you. The terms of appointment for East Burke Senior Center Advisory Board members Norma Klein, Karen Robinson, and Gail Fulbright ended May 31st. All these ladies desire reappointment. The terms are for the remainder of three-year terms ending May 31st, 2020.
Thank you, Madam Clerk. Any questions on this item? All right. Without objection, this item will remain on the agenda. Item number five, community development acceptance of amended trail easement agreement from South Point Owners Association, presented by Tim Johnson, Community Development Operations Manager. Tim.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Good afternoon, board members. When South Point Community was originally established there at Lake James, Crescent gave Burke County a trail easement across the entrance of the community for the what was then the Lake James Loop Trail. After we took a closer look at the easement, both us as well as the South Point Owners Association, we realized it was not ideal for sustainability and safety reasons. So South Point has agreed to grant Burke County an amended easement. The original easement that we had with them was for 8.3 acres. They are granting us another 8.5 acres, and we are relinquishing rights to about 4 acres of that original easement. So we'll have an easement of about 12.93 acres across the entrance of South Point. Anybody has any questions, I'll be glad to address those.
All right, thank you, Tim. Any questions for Tim on this matter? All right, hearing none, this item will remain on the agenda without objection. Tim, thank you for being here, and I see that you're kind of a short timer. Thank you for your good service to us, and I forget the date when you were leaving us, but when?
About a month or so. So I said
about a month. Okay, got a little time. Well,
thank you.
Okay, we'll keep working on you then. All right, item number six, County Manager, Memorandum of Understanding with Sunrise Rotary Club in relation to the World War II Memorial at our courthouse.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Members of the board, we've had some interaction with the Sunrise Rotary in regards to the upkeep as far as mowing, and we've prepared a memorandum of agreement that outlines who does what. And as a municipality, we're already there. Anticipated being in a building expenditure to us to do these things and help the Rotary Club out. And again, this just kind of formalizes who is responsible for doing well.
All right, thank you. Mr. Manager, any questions on this item? All right, thank you. We'll leave that on the agenda without objection. Item number seven, finance amendment to capital project ordinance. Mr. Trimes.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. After the board adopted the capital project ordinance for the new elementary school, it came to our attention that there had been an item that was not included, that item being a cost for a turn lane and I guess some lights and things like that. So we have a need to to amend the adopted ordinance in the amount of $879,000 to cover the engineering and construction cost to allow the all that work to be done. We have some folks here from the school system. If the board has any questions about what's actually going to take place or what's happening on that. But the funding would come from the school 1 cent sales tax fund. There's approximately ballpark is $6 million fund balance available, so this would not cause a serious problem to the fund. So we have the money to accomplish this if the board is willing.
All right, thank you, Paul. Any questions concerning this matter?
I don't want to belabor this, but I thought we did we not talk about this early on about this road construction in the front? Was this inadvertently left off?
I think I'm Doug Setch with Auxiliary Services, Brook County Schools. We did talk about it, and I think it's the estimate that we've gotten is more than what we anticipated it was going to be. We got enlisted the services of JMT Engineering. That's $79,000 of that amount, which will be the traffic signalization there at the corner of Sanford Drive and Bushell Street. DOT with the requirements for the light there will be a turn lane coming from Catawba Meadows Park, be a left hand, and then there they would need a right hand turn lane coming from the post office in that direction. And then with the signalization, that's where the greenway will be crossing Sanford Drive, and with everything that goes in with that. And that's a best guess estimate on the cost of this renovation. Hopefully, we bid it out. It's going to be less than that, but that was their estimate this time.
Any other questions? Couldn't provide a deputy to stand there without all that.
I'm one that's brave enough.
Okay. All right. So, without objection, this will remain on the agenda. Thank you, Doug.
Thank you.
All right, item number 8, statewide emergency management, mutual aid assistance agreement from our fire marshal, Mike Willis. Thank you, Mike.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, board members. This is an annual agreement that is signed between each county and the tribal representation of the county to the county to the state emergency management agency, and just to give authority, grant authority to assist and receive mutual aid between both counties.
All right, thank you, Mike. This is a routine item. Any questions for Mike on this item? All right, hearing none, without objection, this item will remain on the agenda. Thank you, Mike. Item number 9, Health Department Child Protection and Child Fatality Team, fiscal year 16-17 report presented by Kathy Gray, CPCF member. Hey, Kathy.
I know that all of you received the report, and I just wanted to highlight a couple of items. The Child Protection and Child Fatality Team for fiscal year 2017, Burke County, we reviewed 12 child deaths and identified 0 system problems and recommendations for future prevention. So that's a huge success for our county that we were unable to identify any system problems. We also did some in-service for our team members on meth and cocaine. As we all know, our county is really suffering from substance abuse issues, and it's affecting many of our agencies. So we've done a lot of education. We also had some funding available. We bought DARE Camp t-shirts. There's going to be a DARE Camp this summer. We bought the t-shirts for that camp. Our committee members are going to be volunteering at that camp. And we also provided medication lock boxes for kinship providers for families who were providing care for children, for their family members who had been brought into foster care. So those are some of our highlights.
All right. Thank you, Kathy. Any questions for Kathy on this report? right, hearing none, without objection, this item will remain on the agenda. Item number 10, library. C.B. Hildebrand and Valdez Library Staffing Changes, presented by Jim Wilson, our library director. Afternoon, Jim.
Good afternoon. Thank you all very much. I just want to tell you how much we appreciate the additional staffing for our new library in Hildebrand. We would like, however, to make a swap of staffing. We'd like to swap the new full-time library assistant that would be a Hildebrand for the full-time library program specialist at Valdez. So there's no effect on the budget. We want to swap those two positions. That will give us a better balance at both sites between programmers and customer service. If we leave it the way it is, we'll only have one programmer at Valdez, excuse me, one programmer at Hildebrand. We won't be able to expand children's programming. If we put two down there, we can do as much programming at Hildebrand as we do at Morganton and Valdez.
All right, gentlemen, you've heard this information. Any questions for Jim? Hearing none, this item will remain without objection on the agenda. Thank you, Jim.
Thank you.
All right, items 11, 12, 13, Tax Department, EMS Collection Report, Tax Administrator, Danny Eisenhower. Hey, Danny.
Gentlemen, EMS Collection Report for May of 17, can I just give you a percent? We're at 86.54% collected.
Any questions on the EMS Collection Report?
Carry on with the tax collection report. Tax collection report through June. This gets us for the year. I'm glad to say that we have met our challenge of making budget for each category. Just to read them off here, current year taxes were a total of 101.27% collected. Delinquent taxes were at 124.27% collected. Late list penalty, we're at 115.68% collected. And whenever you break out the property tax, between regular property tax and motor vehicle, we were 100.65% on property tax and 107.15% on motor vehicle.
All right. Any questions for Danny on this report? All right, here and then that will remain without objection on the agenda. Item 13, release refund report for June 2017.
Release refunds, releases in the amount of $4,598.72 and BTS vehicle tax system adjustments, or excuse me, proration in the amount of $1,693.83.
Any questions for Danny on this report? All right, hearing none, without objection, this item will remain on the agenda.
Mr. Chairman, if I could make one comment for everyone's benefits, the tax notices for 2017 are at the printers, and they should be in the mail around the 13th of the month. They should show up on the website tomorrow.
All right, well, I'm sure everybody is eagerly waiting those. Danny?
Thank you for that little plug so we can keep those collection rates up.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
All right, this brings us to item six, item for decision. First item on decision items is from County Manager RFQ for Engineering Services, Highway 18 South, CDBG project, presented by County Manager and our new County General Services Director, Miles Shepherd. Miles, good to see you.
Thank you. Thanks for allow me to begin work at your county in the last week. I'm enjoying it. Appreciate that.
Glad to have you.
Well, on the agenda, for the first time, we've got a CDBG grant for your water main on 18 South. And your program guidelines require proposals of qualifications for engineering services. We received six proposals from engineering firms. The committee was consisted of myself, County Finance Director Paul Allen, and Chairman Jeff Ritten. The engineering firms that submitted proposals were Municipal Engineering Company, PA, West Consultant, PLLC, Clayton Engineering and Design, LKC Engineering, PLLC, Sintera, and Madden and Craig. We still have to analyze those and make a recommendation, and that will be on the
not, any questions from Miles on this item? Hearing none, without objection, this item will remain on the agenda. Thank you, Miles. Appreciate you being here. Item number two, TBA resolution calling for referendum on alcohol sales in unincorporated areas of Burke County, presented by Ed Phillips. Ed. And I see Jerry also. Jerry, you can come on up and have a seat if you like. Yes, Madam Clerk, if you will note that Commissioner Taylor has arrived, even though he does have on a Carolina blue shirt, that's okay.
Mr. Chairman, thanks for having us. I believe you all have a copy of our resolution from the Burke County Tourism Development Authority and also from the Chamber of Commerce. Could start in many areas, but we think that it's time for the people of Burke County to have a vote on whether they want to allow beer and wine sales in the county. It's a it's an idea of fairness in the county. It's an idea of economic development in the county. Most of the municipalities in Burke County have already voted through referendum to allow this, and so we believe that this is the year 2017 to put it before the people of Burke County.
All right, thank you, Ed. Jerry, anything to add on that?
I would just add that the Chamber, by principle, supports free enterprise. That's the entire reason Chambers of Commerce were founded. And this, to us, is an example of that. As you know, we usually come down on the side of anything that promotes the establishment of new business. We think that is a uniquely American right. And anything that we can remove or that we can put in place that encourages new business, to us, is a good thing for the county in a lot of respects. I guess the other principle I'd echo Ed here is that, of course, we believe as well in democracy and the right of self-determination for our residents to live in the unincorporated areas to make a decision on this matter. So for us, while the focus tends to be on the sale of and consumption of alcohol on premises, off premises, we could expand that belief and that support into almost any kind of business, and we'd be taking the same position. So with that, our board voted unanimously to create a resolution that supports the TDA's resolution. And that's my presence here today is representing that group, our board, plus our 430-some odd businesses all across Burke County.
All right, thank you, Jerry. Any questions for Ed or Jerry on this matter, gentlemen?
I just ask Ed a different question. On the sales on Sunday, is that come from the legislature? That's not a local. That won't be a local referendum. That'll be legislature.
Senate Bill 155 was passed. Sunday sales will still have to be approved in each community. Right now, that would impact Morganton, probably Valdez. They have restaurants that would serve mixed drinks on Sunday. I don't think there are any in the county that I'm aware of that fall under any special regulation or legislation, but if that were to happen under that law that just passed, the county commissioners would still have to authorize that by resolution.
So the municipalities are the ones that...
That's correct.
Any other questions on this matter?
Mr. Chairman, a couple of comments, if you don't mind, please. If I may first, apologize for being late. We just simply had guests and company, and Shirley got a big watermelon, and we lost track of time. But anyhow, several of us went to mental health issue training. You were there, too, with Rich. And they stated 1 in 4 people had mental health issues. And the reason for that mental health issues was lifestyle, drinking, overdosing, and all that kind of stuff. And, you know, just as an offering of where I think this board needs to also be thinking about is, you know, are we enabling people to, even death, as far as that goes, commit suicide and whatever, by enhancing the opportunity to drink, et cetera, et cetera. And then I know we're going to hear it sometime from the sheriff because the people being drunk, et cetera, in outlying parts of the county, not just the incorporated cities. And then the rehabilitation costs for all those people who can't control themselves. And I just feel like that there's much more to this question than just an opportunity for somebody to make some money. And, you know, it weighs heavy on my heart. I don't speak for the other commissioners except to say that it's not just a tourism question or a profit or entitlement question to me. So I just want to tell you where I stood. Hopefully it would trigger some thinking on y'all's behalf. But in today's society, it's acceptable would be a light word for it. It's sometimes in some areas it's almost demanding, but I still think we need to, as a board, or I do, I know myself, think more than just that it's a tourism question. Or I know I have some people down in my neighborhood too, who own stores, who think it ought to be there, but it's still a big question. And I'll answer the question.
Chairman, I just believe from the figures I read that even with all the breweries and that and the different venues in Burke County, I believe DUI is in the sheriff's lot. I read that they're down some, and that's hard to figure out, but I think people are getting smarter and having a designated driver is the thing. I know I've got grandkids and they go out there. They always have a designated driver.
Any other questions on this tonight? All right. Hearing none, this item will remain on your decision agenda. This brings us to item number 3, Clerk, Performance Animal Advisory Board. Madam Clerk.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, members of the board. At your seat, you should have a handout from me on this item. As part of the animal ordinance the board adopted recently, Section 6.7 created the Animal Advisory Board. It's a 7-member board with 2 seats being a member of a 501c3 animal rescue agency or foster agency, a veterinarian, practicing or retired, a Board of Health member or designee excluding the health director, an at-large pet owner, a law enforcement officer excluding animal control officers, another seat for a member of a 501c3 animal rescue agency or foster agency, and an at-large non-pet owner. I just wanted to let you know that I have a number of applications for several of the seats. For seat number 1, we have 3 applications on file. Their nonprofit has been verified with the Secretary of State's office. And I have spoken to all these ladies, and they are providing a letter from their nonprofit indicating their association or affiliation with the nonprofit. We do need for seat number 2, the veterinarian's office, the veterinarian seat. We do need applications for that seat, and I reached out to my own personal vets and encouraged them to apply. So. We'll be sending something out later this week directly to our local vets, making them aware of this opportunity to serve. Seat number 3, the Board of Health member or designee. The health director is working on finding a Board of Health member to fill this seat. Seat number 4 is for the at-large pet owner. We have currently 3 applications on file for that seat. All but Ms. Steele. I've spoken with them, and they were happy to provide documentation stating, verifying that they are a pet owner. I have not heard back from Ms. Steele as of this afternoon. Seat number five is the law enforcement officer, excluding animal control officers, and Captain Jeff Robinson has submitted an application for that seat. And then seat six is, again, a member of the 501c3 rescue or foster agency. We have three applications, which are the same three for seat number one, and their letters will be forthcoming. I do not have any applications for seat number seven, which is the at-large non-pet owner. So if you are satisfied with the number of applications we have thus far, you know, we can certainly move forward. If you'd like, I can re-advertise again in Sunday's paper if you want to try to get additional applications. It is on our website, and we did send it out to the seniors' email list, which has about 300 folks on it.
You're planning already to work on the vet?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Well, there's always hope, but I would encourage you to reach out to your personal vet.
Any interest on that?
I've not had any knocking my door down there.
Have we placed this on our website, Facebook, and all that?
Mm-hmm, we have.
Mm-hmm. Any other thoughts on those, gentlemen? I think we've got a fair representation out there so far, other than those that are highlighted in yellow. It sounds like the clerk's working on those. Questions? Hearing none, Madam Clerk, I'll remain on the agenda. All right, that brings us to items 7, 8, and 9, reports, other discussions. Any other matters to come before us this afternoon, gentlemen? Madam Clerk, anything? All right, hearing none, I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
Chairman, give me one privilege. Yes, item three, and I think that lady goes to church with you, but I promised my daughter I would tell her what a good candidate, she said that would be. So I'm living up to on item three on the DSS board.
Oh, okay.
Lisa Dean.
Oh.
Yes, she has.
She worked with her son, and she told me to make sure I told her that the way to do it.
Agree wholeheartedly. Any other comments? All right, hearing none, I'll entertain a motion to adjourn. All in favor say aye. Opposed, no. Thank you very much.